all my things are coming back. Job rose up and fell down on the ground and worshipped the Lord. And said that may the name of the Lord be praised. Even if you can take everything that he has, he's going to remain to. And the devil's like, no, it's not going to happen. And God says, go and take it. Are you with me? Will you remain? Let's continue. Job 2, verse 1 to 3.
On another day, the angels came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan also came with them to present himself before him. And the Lord said to Satan, "Where have you come from?" Satan answered to the Lord, "From roaming through the earth, going to and fro on it."
Continue.
Then the Lord said to Satan, "Have you considered my servant Job? There is no one on earth like him. He is blameless and upright, a man who fears God and shuns evil. And he still maintains his integrity, though you incited me against him to ruin him without any reason." Skin for skin, Satan replied, "A man would give all he has for his own life. But now stretch out your hand and strike his flesh and bones, and he will surely curse you to your face." The Lord said to Satan, "Very well then, he is in your hands, but you must spare his life."
Hallelujah. Now, where we are reading, again, another day, the angels, the sons of God, came before the Lord, and the fallen angel, the devil, was also present. Hallelujah. God knows the devil, asked him, "Hey, where have you been? Are you with me?" And he says, "Up and down the earth." And then God said, "Have you again noticed Job? There is none like him. He fears me. Although you have incited me against him." In other words, you have made me to permit you to touch him without a cause. Are you with me? Still, he is holding up on his integrity. Still, he has not forsaken his integrity. In other words, still the man has decided to cling on me. Are you with me? And then the devil said this time around, "Okay, it's fine. But please allow me now to touch his skin." Because the first time he said, "I must touch everything around him. Cattle, whatsoever, camels, including his children." The only thing that he did not touch was his wife. Are you with me? I do not know why the devil left the wife.
touch her baby.
Not that I wanted the devil to touch her, but I believe the devil must have had some hopes that the wife is going to lead Job astray. I do not know. Anyway, let's continue. Now, the Lord said to Job, okay, it's fine. Now go and touch him. Touch his bones and his flesh. Continue, but do not touch his life. Are you with me? Again, the Lord trusted Job. Which means that at times you may be inflicted by sickness even in your body. Maybe the devil would have said, it's because you have been protecting this one so long. Are you with me? That's why she has been so faithful. That's why she has been living a holy life. Give you an example. But the Bible doesn't tell us that this was the first and the last day the devil went before the Lord. Actually, the book of Revelation tells us that he is accusing us before the Lord. Maybe he's been saying, this one is faithful before you because you are protecting him. It's not because he really loves you. I do not know. And God will be like, I know this one. Are you with me? I know. I know this one. And then, verse 7. So when Satan fought from the presence of the Lord and smote Job with sore boils from the sole of his foot unto his crown, and he took him in posture to scrape himself withal, and he sat down among the ashes. Verse number 9. Then said his wife unto him, dost thou still retain thine integrity? Curse God and die. Maybe that's the reason we left the devil. Are you with me? Read verse 9 there in your simple English. Where we can hear.
His wife said to him, are you still maintaining your integrity? Curse God and die.
You hear that? Curse God and die. In other words, are you still holding on this God of yours? That was the question. I do not know. But maybe the devil knew the wife, but this one is not strong as Job. I will mean, maybe, I'm not saying. But you see the response here? That the wife is saying. The wife was okay with Job losing all the other things. Are you with me? But now when it came to his flesh, are you still? Are you with me? But let's hear what Job said. Mister.
He replied, you are talking like a foolish woman. Shall we accept good from God and not trouble? In all this, Job did not sin in what he said.
Hallelujah. Now, I do not know what is it that you are going to go through. Are you with me? But I know for sure. It wasn't the first and the last time that somebody had to go through things. Not because they have done something wrong. Are you with me? What you will need to do is to know and understand that. Even when it is raining, even when there is sunshine, God will still be there with you. Are you with me? You need to understand that. The presence of God does not mean the absence. Are you with me? Doesn't mean that your parents are not going to die. Hey, Pastor, why are you now? No. It doesn't mean that. Thank the Lord while you still have them. Again, when they pass on, when they pass, that time comes. Thank the Lord that you had that time that you had with them. Are you with me? One day they will live. And we do not mean that God has forsaken you now. We don't even know the circumstances in which they will leave you. Are you with me? But God will still be God. You need to speak like Job and say, shall we accept only the good from the Lord? Are you with me? Pastor, this one is not for me. Are you with me? It's for all of us. Thank the Lord. Why? You still have all that you have. But do understand that even when you lose things, it won't necessarily mean that now the Lord has forsaken you. When things stop going your way, it's nice when things go our way. Are you with me? We even have the courage to come and testify. I thank the Lord, saints. I'm getting distinctions. Are you with me? What happens now when the decisions are not there and we are failing? I'm just speaking about a reality very close to us. Why am I failing now? Who said you're not going to fail? Are you with me? God must be God. I know people that have questioned God because they have failed. Now, Job did not sin in all this. And the Lord was still with Job. Are you with me? God was with him. And Job understood that fully. God was still with him. You need to understand as well. I do not know what is it that you are going to go through, and I won't be there. But the Lord shall surely be with you. Be like Job. Understand that this is your Calvary. This is your Gethsemane. This is your way. You have to pass them. Now you don't get a lot of amen in such. How am I lying? But if I was saying that you're more than a conqueror. You hear me because I was even saying Jesus. You see? You are not the tail, but the head. No, speaking scripture, reality. John 16, verse 33. John 16, 33.
John 16, verse 33. I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble. But take heart, I have overcome the world.
I am telling you this so that in me you may have peace. Are you with me? In this world you are going to have troubles. What kind of a trouble? Has assured us we are going to have troubles. Are we together? But you need to take courage in this fact. I have overcome this world. Are you with me? The source of your troubles has already been overcome. Take courage in that. Matthew 28, verse 20. Which means we are guaranteed to have troubles as believers. Are you with me? Yeah, we are guaranteed. Which means that if we do not encounter troubles, we must go and ask for them. No, guys, let me say this to you. Without troubles, challenges, we will never see the power of God. Are you with me? You will never see the power of God. Let me make a simple example. Unless there is a sick somebody, can we see that God heals? Can we see that? We won't. But if there is someone that is sick, he or she comes here, we pray for them, then we are going to say, praise the Lord. Are you with me? God indeed heals. The same with you. You are going to rise here. Here I've seen the Lord, saints. Are you with me? We have got a testimony. And by the way, read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. You will never see God just appearing when things were rosy. Are you with me? Just for the sake of appearing that God showed up. Are you with me? And didn't do anything, didn't say anything. Are you with me? You will never go through the whole Bible. Will never. Whenever God appeared, there was a need. He appeared and did something. Let me simple example. When God wanted to draw Moses' attention, appeared through a burning bush. Are you with me? Not that God wanted to just demonstrate that a bush can burn without finishing. Are you with me? He wanted to draw Moses' attention and then from there go and deliver his people. Are you with me? During the time of Daniel, during the time of those three guys, Meshach, Abednego, they said, we see someone there walking like the sons of God. Are you with me? An angel of the Lord was with them, sent by God. God appeared with them through the angel. Then I and you today say, unge nanat, but you do not want to go through. Are we together? It's nice to sing. Are we with me? It's just nice to sing. It's just nice to sing. But it's not nice to go through. Hey, my brother, my sister, you are going to sing the song better one day with a deeper understanding once you have gone through something. That indeed, I have seen him going through with me. 28, verse 20.
And teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you, and surely I am with you always to the very end of the age.
Hallelujah. Another assurance from God is that he is going to be with us always. You hear that? Second, to the very end of the world. Oh God, I'm in a dream. I'm in a dream. These are shortcuts. with us always. With us all the time. Which means even when we go through those things, we must know He is still with us. At times it doesn't feel like, but He's still with. And the presence of the Holy Spirit, again, doesn't mean that they won't be there. The challenges, tribulations, and troubles. When you read in Esther number 2, the Holy Spirit descended on the day of the Pentecost. 1, 2, 3, chapter number 3. They healed that man who could not walk. Then in chapter number 4, the troubles began. They were imprisoned. God was still with them. Are you with me? God was still with them. But He allowed them to be imprisoned. The Holy Spirit was there with them. Let's read Acts 4, 29, 31. Acts 4, 29 to 31. Quickly.
Acts 4, 29 to 31. Okay. Heaven must receive him until the time comes.
Okay, Acts 4, 29.
Sorry.
Yes.
After further threats, they let them go and could not decide how to punish them, because all the people were praising God for what had happened. For the man who was miraculously healed was over 40 years old. On their release, Peter and John went back to their own people and reported all that the chief priests and the elders had said to them. When they heard this, they raised their voices together in praise to God. Sovereign God, they said, you made the heavens and the earth and the sea and everything in them. You spoke by the Holy Spirit through the mouth of your servant, our father David. Why do the nations rage and peoples plot in vain? The kings of the earth rise up and the rulers band together against the Lord and against his anointed one.
All right. Thank you. Now, where we are reading, it was after these brethren were threatened by the Sadducees and the high priest because of the miracle that had been done. Now in verse number 29, this is them praying. And now, Lord, behold their threatenings, grant unto thy servant that with boldness they may speak thy word by stretching forth thine hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done by the name of thy child, or thy holy child Jesus. And when they had prayed, the place was shaken where they were assembled together, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and they spake the word of God with boldness. Now, we find the apostles praying. After they've been detained, they pray. Are you with me? And after they prayed, God showed to them that He was with them by shaking the place where they were, and also they were filled with the Holy Ghost again. Are you with me? Otherwise, the filling of the Holy Ghost didn't take place once. Are we together? Yeah, that's why the word of God says, be filled with the Holy Spirit. Are you with me? In other words, it's not something that should happen and stops. You must be continually filled with the Holy Spirit. Now, this is what happened here. God shakes the place to show them that I am with you. Guess what? But the troubles did not stop. Now, I do not know what way God is going to solve or come through for you in your troubles. It might be not the way in which you are hoping for. Am I speaking to somebody? And what I like about them, they did not say, God, please stop. They just said, give us boldness so that we can speak your word with boldness. Give us strength. Grant that miracles and signs may happen in your name. And guess what? They continued to preach. And even their troubles ceased not. In Acts 5, please give me just 3 minutes to wrap up. I'm aware that I'm already beyond your time. Yes. Acts 5, verse 40 to 41. And to him they agreed when they had called the apostles and beaten them, they commanded that they should not speak in the name of Jesus and let them go. And they departed from their presence, and they departed from the presence of the council, rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer shame for his name. You hear this one? They were beaten. But these guys, they were very happy that they had been beaten for the name of Christ. How many of us, if they can just come here, other people of other beliefs, and they beat us? What is it that you are doing? How many of us can come out of this building and say, hey, we are here today, finally we have been beaten for our faith? How many of us? Hey, Pastor, you're exaggerating. This is what happened. How many of us? Is there any of you? Don't lie. Hallelujah. It's not this. But these guys, they rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer shame for his name. You hear that? They rejoiced. And they continued. Are you with me? Now let's continue. I'm just showing you this. Acts 6, verse 8 to 10. And Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among the people. Now, when he was elected, one of the things that we are told about him, he was full of the Holy Ghost. Now, verse number 9. Then there arose certain of the synagogues, which is called the synagogue of the Libertines, the Cyrenians, the Alexandrians, and of the Sicilia of Asia, disputing with Stephen. And they were not able to resist the wisdom and the spirit by which he spake. In other words, the people that wanted to stop him, but they could not. Now, let's continue. Chapter 7. Verse 54 to 58. When they heard the things, they were cut to heart and they gnashed on him with their teeth. In other words, Stephen responded to their accusation. Verse 55. But he, being full of the Holy Ghost, looked up steadfastly into heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing on the right hand of God, and said, behold, I see the heavens open and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of God. Then they cried out with a loud voice and stopped their ears and ran upon him with one accord. Verse 58. And cast him out of the city, stoned him, and the witnesses laid down their clothes at a young man's feet whose name was Saul. In other words, we see that God was indeed with this man. The heavens were opened while he was there in front of his people. But that did not stop him from being stoned. Are you with me? It did not. The last scripture, then we are going to pray. Acts 14, verse 22. Acts 14, verse 22. Confirming the souls of the disciples and exhorting them to continue in the faith, and that we must, through much tribulation, enter into the kingdom of God. Read from your version. Acts 14, verse 22. Let's rise up so we can pray.
Strengthening the disciples and encouraging them to remain true to the faith, we must go through many hardships to enter the kingdom of God, they said.
Hallelujah. Let's rise up so we can pray. We must go through many hardships in order to enter into the kingdom. We must go through many tribulations, hardships, troubles. When he sees